Qsymia is one of the few drugs approved by the FDA specifically for the long-term treatment of obesity. It's available by prescription, but at the time of this recording, not approved for use in Canada. Hi, I'm Dr. Brian Young, a naturopathic doctor in Toronto. Full disclosure, I don't have personal experience with patients using Qsymia, so for this video, I've asked some of my colleagues in the US who do have experience treating patients with Qsymia. I'll be summarizing their professional experiences as well as what I know about the medication to shed some light into what you might expect if you try it yourself. Qsymia is a combination drug of both phentermine and topiramate. Phentermine itself is actually a commonly used weight loss medication. It has amphetamine-like stimulant properties which causes appetite suppression, but also has some of the potentially addictive qualities typically found in amphetamine drugs like Adderall. Topiramate is used to treat epilepsy or migraine headaches. Its weight loss potential was recognized when patients being treated for epilepsy and seizures were found to have lost weight, as well as a reduction in visceral fat. Together, both drugs work synergistically to aid in weight loss. How does it work? Both drugs combine to make Qsymia primarily an appetite suppressant. Phentermine already works as an appetite suppressant. Amphetamine-like stimulants often suppress appetite by stimulating the sympathetic nervous system, also known as the fight or flight nervous system. Normally, this system is activated during times of acute stress and prepares your body for fight or flight by getting your muscles ready to act. It also shuts down unnecessary systems in your body, like your digestive system. A side effect of this shutdown is a suppression of appetite. The way by which topiramate helps with weight loss is not exactly known. Studies on animals show a lot of potential mechanisms, like increased energy usage, decreased energy use efficiency, and appetite suppression. In humans, the way it works best appears to be by appetite suppression. Side effects. Due to its effects on the central nervous system, common neurological side effects include tingling to your hands and feet, dizziness, and headaches. The drowsiness effect of topiramate is somewhat counteracted by the stimulant effects of phentermine. However, people still sometimes experience the negative effects of taking both phentermine, such as insomnia, nervousness, and heart palpitations, as well as topiramate, like fatigue and drowsiness. Gastrointestinal issues are also common, such as constipation or stomach pain. In addition to suppressing your appetite, it may also modify the mouthfeel of some foods by changing the taste of these foods or causing your mouth to feel very dry. It's also recommended you drink plenty of water while on Qsymia since it might increase your risk of developing kidney stones. Qsymia is avoided in conditions like hyperthyroidism, glaucoma, or a history of stroke since it can worsen those conditions. It's also contraindicated in pregnancy, as it can harm your fetus. Qsymia will also interact with many medications and can potentially cause life-threatening medical issues if taken with certain medications, like monoamine oxidase inhibitors. So there are a lot of potentially serious side effects and drug interactions with Qsymia. You'll need to talk to your doctor before taking it. Is it addictive? Qsymia contains phentermine, which is considered an amphetamine-like stimulant. Amphetamine stimulants have a long history of having addictive qualities, and being on amphetamines for a long period of time can increase one's dependence and cravings to continually use it. Interestingly, Qsymia does not appear to have as strong addictive qualities, and patients who use Qsymia for long periods of time do not seem to develop a strong physiological dependence or craving for the drug as often as other amphetamines. However, while there may not be a strong medical addiction, some patients may, in a sense, still be addicted to its weight loss effects, since some patients do report that rebound weight gain is common after discontinuing Qsymia, so they continue to take Qsymia to prevent this rebound. Nevertheless, if you discontinue Qsymia, you will need to be slowly weaned off of it, especially since sudden discontinuation of topiramate, which is in Qsymia, can also potentially cause seizures. Is it effective? Well, if the research studies are to be believed, Qsymia appears to be one of the more effective drugs for weight loss approved by the FDA. While it doesn't work for everyone, many people find it's quite effective as an appetite suppressant, reducing your desire and need to eat. The way it reduces your food intake may range from a simple reduction in hunger to changing the taste and feel of food in your mouth, potentially giving you less enjoyment out of eating. What to expect? If you have issues dealing with hunger and appetite and tend to overeat, Qsymia can be quite useful in suppressing that appetite. I recommend trying to implement lifestyle habits that can help manage hunger first before trying Qsymia, since some of its side effects may not make it appropriate for some people to take. You will need to see your doctor about whether it's safe for you to use. If you do end up using it, you will be slowly titrated on and off the medication to safely take it and help reduce side effects. Also keep in mind that Qsymia can be quite expensive at around a few hundred dollars a month and is rarely covered by insurance. Don't neglect to implement a proper weight loss diet while on Qsymia. I recommend following a stricter dietary routine since Qsymia can help you to more easily adhere to dietary restrictions and eliminate foods you shouldn't be eating. Do you have experiences with Qsymia? Let me know in the comments down below. Also, let me know if there are other weight loss medications you'd like me to talk about. And if you found this video helpful, please leave me a like. As before, I'm Dr. Brian Young, bringing you weight loss info on this channel. Subscribe and hit the notification bell if you're interested in learning more, and share it with someone you know can use the help.